They've had more farewells than John Farnham, but the end has finally come for the F111. Jonathan Lee joins us from Amberley, where Jonathan, the Jets are now grounded for good.
Yeah, Max, these are being replaced by the better, but not faster, FA18 Super Hornets. The remaining pigs, as they're affectionately known, will become museum pieces, but not before one last mission and one last chance to say goodbye. There aren't many workhorses that in middle age, on the day they would be mothballed, can still strike the same ore on their last mission as they did on their first. But at 500 knots, pulling 6 Gs over their base at Amberley, an F111 makes it look easy. It's little wonder a crowd had come to wave the Jets goodbye. They took their photos and the pilots took theirs. The cost of upkeep and the march of technology have made the old bombers redundant. But this was a day for history.
Now the old girl is, will look good on display, but on the ground.
Pilot Mickey Gray is too much the professional to be distracted by emotion. The RAF's had lots of planes since 1917. It'll have lots more. Still, this last mission, this special moment, he shared with his dad, who didn't live to see it.
I also took the crest from my late father, who was CO-22 squadron, a reserve squadron.
The Lord's my shepherd, I am not want.
5 airmen lost their lives flying F-111s. They were remembered too. Even the sky was sombre, making one last flypast something to be glimpsed and savoured.
The cockpit may be old and the avionics outdated, but even today the F-111 is still the fastest plane of its type anywhere in the world.
Then one by one they came back to Earth, this time for good. Relics of fading wars and fireworks displays, left not to rust, but to go out fittingly with a roar. At Amberley, Jonathan Lee, 10 News.